The bell in front of us was the official symbol of the Olympic Games in 1936 and originally hung in the bell tower. With the ringing of the bell on the first day, the Games were officially opened, and the bell also rung to end them on the last day during the closing ceremony. And so it was an essential part of the framing spectacle of the Games. Today, the bell stands as a monument in front of the southern gate of the stadium and marks, quite literally, the rise and fall of National Socialism. In its centre, you can see the German Imperial Eagle carrying the Olympic rings in its claws. To dramatise the image, the eagle pulls two of the rings upwards, alienating the logo of the IOC. Below the eagle, you can read the slogan of the Games: I call the youth of the world. This steel bell, weighing about 10 tons, was supposed to accompany the youth on their way to the stadium with its tolling. Furthermore, it directed attention towards the Hall of Langemark in the lower part of the building. The place served nationalistically exaggerated rituals in remembrance of the fallen German soldiers of World War I. The use of steel for the bell founding itself was unusual. Normally, bronze was preferred because of its better sound quality. But the choice of material can be explained by the fact that the bell was donated by a large steel syndicate. This sector of industry had many reasons to be generous at the time, as in 1936 rearmament was running up to full scale and the Third Reich was filling the purses of the steel and arms industrialists. The Olympic Village in Dargaud-Döberitz was also created in the context of this increased militarisation. From the outset, it was designed with a view to its subsequent use as a barracks. After the Games, the German army, the Wehrmacht, moved into the premises. If you now take a look at the side of the bell turned towards the stadium, you will see one of the main symbols of the National Socialists, a swastika, engraved onto its lower edge. This shows how strongly the Games were connected to the ideology of National Socialism and to what extent this was displayed publicly. The entire city of Berlin was clad in flags, and the national flag with the swastika dominated all. National Socialist symbols could also be found on the stadium, as you can see on the photo showing one pair of the twin towers. On the Saxon Tower, you can also see a round-shaped swastika. In the area above the balcony of honour, the standard of Adolf Hitler belonged to the basic layout alongside the Olympic flag. You can also see that the bell was hit by a large projectile. It's still not entirely clear how that happened. It's assumed that a Soviet soldier aimed a deliberate shot at the bell during the Battle for Berlin in 1945. But there are also anecdotes suggesting that a German anti-aircraft gun operator or a British soldier did it. The war-damaged tower with the bell was blown up in 1947. This was done so at the behest of the British, as Charlottenburg was in their sector after Berlin had been divided between the four Allied powers. The bell tower was re-erected at the beginning of the 1960s. For the Football World Championships in 2006, it was completely renovated together with the middle stands. Today, you can reach the top of the 77-metre tower comfortably by lift, and here visitors have a great view over both the sports park and the city of Berlin.